हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द फिफ्थ चैप्टर ऑफ फर्स्ट फ्लाइट नेम द 100 ड्रेसेस. इन दिस स्टोरी वेंडा वॉज अ लिटिल गर्ल. शी लिव्ड इन पोलैंड. शी वॉज ए पोल. हर फुल नेम वॉज वेंडा पेट्रोंस्की. हर पेरेंट्स लिव्ड इन अ लिटिल अमेरिकन टाउन. द चिल्ड्रन एट वेंडाज स्कूल वर ऑल अमेरिकन्स. दे थॉट दैट वेंडा हैड अ स्ट्रेंज नेम. The American students thought that Wanda was a strange name. That was not easy to say. So they would make fun of Wanda. Wanda was a poor girl. She always wore a faded blue dress that looked very shabby, but it was clean dress. Maddie and Peggy were two of the girls in Wanda's class. Peggy would always tease Wanda for her poor dress. She with a crowd of girls would surround Wanda and ask jokingly, "How many dresses do you have hanging up in your closet?" Wanda would say, 100. She would say that she had 100 dresses. At this, girls would burst out laughing. Sometimes Peggy would tease her with, "How many shoes did you say you had?" 60 pairs, all lined up in my closet. It was the answer of Wanda, she would say. Thus this game went on day after day. Wanda was teased by those American girls. It was always Peggy who took the lead in teasing Wanda. Maddie did sometimes feel that they were being cruel to Wanda. But she had not the courage to speak up. However, she wished Peggy would stop teasing Wanda Petrowski. Maddie herself was a poor girl, and she knew how badly Wanda could be feeling at their teasing. Once she tried to write a note to Peggy about this, but then she tore it, fearing that she would become a new target for Peggy and others. So Maddie did not have the courage to say that it was bad. Because she feared that she would be target of Peggy for making fun. Maddie was also a poor girl, so she could not show the courage to oppose. There was a drawing contest at a school for boys and girls. The boys were to draw boats and the girls were to design dresses in colors. From among the girls, everyone thought that Peggy would win the contest because she could draw the faces of Phil. She could filmmakers, film stars. She could draw the faces of film stars and also copy same to same from the magazines. She was good at drawing. But when the results were announced, it was Wanda Petronsky who had won the competition. She had submitted not one, not two designs, but 100 designs she made in that contest. Each design was different from the other. In the opinion of judges, each one was worthy of winning the prize. But the day when the results were announced, Wanda was not in the class. She had gone. The next day, there was a letter from Wanda's father that Wanda and her little brother Jack would no longer come to school again because they were teased for their funny names. Wanda could not tolerate, she could not put up with the insults. She was newcomer in the school, but the American students used to tease her, asking the embarrassing questions, how many dresses you have, how many shoes you have. She was made fun of having the strange name Wanda Petronsky that looked for the American girls to say long. It filled many with deep regret. Maddie was regretful for the bad doings, bad behavior with Wanda. Maddie and Peggy and others forced Wanda to leave the town, to leave the school. She cursed herself for remaining silent. She could not show her courage. She could not stop Peggy when Wanda was being teased. That day after school, she and Peggy walked all the way टू वेंडाज हाउस. दे वॉन्टेड टू से सॉरी. दे वॉन्टेड टू टेल हर दैट शी हैड वन द कॉम्पिटिशन एंड ऑल्सो दैट शी शुड नॉट गो अवे. बट वैन दे रीच देयर दे फाउंड दैट पेट्रॉन्स्की फैमिली हैड ऑलरेडी लेफ्ट. दे हैड गॉन. द टू गर्ल्स राइट अ लेटर टू वेंडा पेट्रॉन्स्की एट हर ओल्ड एड्रेस इन विच दे रिक्वेस्टेड टू हर. दे रोड विद रिक्वेस्ट प्लीज फॉरवर्ड रिटेन ऑन द एनविलप. दे वेट फॉर मैनी वीक्स बट देयर इज नो आंसर. एट क्रिसमस टाइम द क्लास टीचर At Christmas time, the class teacher, Miss Mason, gets a letter from Wanda. The teacher reads out Wanda's letter to the class. In it, Wanda has written, I would like the girl Peggy. I would like that girl Peggy to have the drawing of the green dress and her friend Maddie to have the blue one. After school, the two girls walk back home with their drawings carefully held in their hands. Maddie put it on their wall in the bedroom. When she looked at it carefully, tears filled her eyes. It was not merely the drawing of a blue dress, her very head, face and mouth was drawn there. Maddie at once ran to Peggy's house. Peggy had put her drawing face down on the bed. Maddie carefully raised it and studied it. The head and face of that picture looked like Peggy's. Maddie blinked away the tears that came in her eyes. Now, I would like to tell you some main points of the story. Just now I have finished the summary of both 5th and 6th chapter. Now, I am going to tell you some main points of the chapter, part 1st, 5th. They would cover the whole chapter. It was Monday. Wanda Petronsky was not in her seat. She usually sat in a corner in the last row. Even Peggy and Maddie did not notice Wanda's absence that day. It was these two girls who had started the game of fun with Vanda. Vanda was not at all rough or noisy. She was very quiet and hardly said anything at all. Sometimes she twisted her mouth into a sort of smile, but that was all. Vanda came all the way from Bogen's Heights. It is a place where she lived, and her feet were usually covered with mud when she walked into her classroom. But no one really thought much about her when once she was in her seat. But outside the school hours, little groups of girls would surround her and have fun with her. On Tuesday again, Vanda was not in school. Nobody noticed her absence again. On Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, on their way to school, waited for Vanda. They wanted to have some fun with her. Vanda Petronsky was a Polish girl. It was a school in America where she was studying. The American children in the school thought Vanda's name was too long and it was difficult to say. So they would make fun of her name. Vanda was a poor girl and came from Bogen's Heights, where most poor people lived. She always wore the same faded blue dress. Her dress looked shabby, but it was always clean. It was mostly Peggy who led the other girls in having fun with Vanda. She would ask Vanda in mocking courteousness, "How many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet?" "100. "What are they like?" "All silk, I bet." "Yes, all silk, all colors." "How many shoes did you say you had?" 60 pairs, all lined up in my closet." "All alike?" "Oh no, every pair is different, all colors, all lined up." In this way, Vanda Petronsky was teased. They knew that Vanda Petronsky was telling a lie. She was poor. She did not have 60 pairs of shoes. She did not have 100 dresses. It was clear from Vanda's faded blue dress that she was a poor girl. Then why she had said that she had 100 dresses and 60 pairs of shoes? Peggy thought Vanda was too dumb to know they were having fun with her. So she didn't think her game was a cruel one. However, Maddie didn't like the game. She wanted to tell Peggy to stop this game, but she didn't have the courage to speak. On Wednesday, Maddie was happy when Wanda did not come for school. She did not have to make fun of her. She tried to write a note for Peggy that they should stop their cruel game of mocking. But soon she tore the letter up. She feared that she would become Peggy's next target. Peggy would make fun of her sitting in her class. Maddie began to think of the drawing and colors contest that had been held a few days earlier. The results had not yet been declared. Maddie was certain that from among the girls, Peggy was going to win the contest. She could draw the faces of film stars so well and so copy pictures from the magazine. So they believed that Peggy would be winner. The next day, it was drizzling. Wanda was absent this day also. The class teacher, Miss Mason, announced the results. She said that from among the girls, Wanda had won the contest, while others had submitted one or two sketches, but Wanda had submitted not one, not two, but she had submitted 100 designs. They were all different and all beautiful. And in the opinion of the judges, each design was worthy of winning the prize. All the children gave a loud applause. The teacher allowed the children to go to the next room and have a look at those beautiful drawings, those exquisite drawings. Now Wanda proved that she was poor, but she was good at drawing. She proved herself while making the 100 sketches of dresses that she was not happy when the other girls of the class would make fun of her. She would sit in the next to the last seat, in the last row, because she knew her feet were muddy and would leave a lot of mud and dust on the floor. She remained silent in the class. Brenda was really a good girl. She expressed her feelings in her sketches of dresses. She said really in the class that she had 100 dresses. Thank you.